Shall we start our class? What was the last topic we discussed?
The symbol of atoms and is divisible. The topic
we discussed about the Dalton's atomic theory. Yes?
Yes.
There are 6 points are there. I given 6 points.
No, sir.
Yes. The matter is made up of...
You forgot, but I didn't forget.
So, atoms, I mean, any matter is made up of a tiny particles called atoms. That's the first point. And atoms cannot be divided further. Means atoms are indivisible. That's the second point. Atoms combine to form the molecules. Atoms of same element have same similar properties. Atoms of different atoms have the different properties. Yes, these points have given, no?
Yes, sir.
You didn't study, I think. You have to study. See, IIT Foundation means what? You should be ahead from other students. That is the IIT Foundation. Okay. All of your other friends, your friends will be studying this all in the next classes. All extra classes, but you are in this class only you are studying. Okay. So you have to be very, very perfect. What we say that you have to learn. Okay. Okay. So today I am going to discuss about some laws. Okay. Some important laws. And that two laws I am going to discuss you. One is law of conservation of mass. And the second one is law of constant proportions. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
So first I am going to discuss about the law of conservation of mass. Okay. So here what it states, very simple, what it states is mass can neither be created nor destroyed. What it says, mass can neither be created nor destroyed during the chemical reactions, and the total mass of the reactants before the reaction is equal to total mass of the products after the reaction. So first I will write so that you can understand. I will explain you detailedly. Okay. So what it says is the total mass of reactants before reaction is equal to the total mass of products after reaction during chemical reaction. Okay, the same reaction can also be called in simple way. Or, okay, mass can neither be created nor destroyed. First, note down this one. Total mass of reactants, R-E-A-C-T-A-N-T-S. The total mass of reactants before reaction is equal to the total mass of products after reaction during chemical reaction. Return. Yeah, right. Second definition also written, mass can neither be created nor destroyed during chemical reaction. Right. So what's the meaning of this one? What did you understand with this statement?
Mass. The meaning of chemical reaction, mass can neither be created nor destroyed chemical reaction.
Yeah, very good. So the meaning is that, do you know what is with the chemical reaction? So for example you see, you might have learnt carbon, okay, burns in oxygen to form carbon dioxide. I think this reaction is general common reaction. Somewhere you might have studied about this one. Yes or no?
Yes.
So when carbon burns in oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide. So how can we write it as a form of word equation? So carbon. Sorry. Plus oxygen. Okay. Then it gives carbon dioxide. This also somewhere you might have learnt in the 7th class or somewhere, word equations. Did you study this one?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, for example, here carbon atomic mass, otherwise we take, for example, in this way you take, we are taking, for example, 12 grams of carbon we are taking. How much we are taking? 12 grams of carbon. And to burn completely this carbon, okay, it requires oxygen, so in terms of oxygen only anything can burn. So to burn completely this 12 grams of carbon, it requires 32 grams of oxygen. How much oxygen is required?
32
grams of oxygen is required. So now when the carbon is burning in presence of 32 grams of carbon oxygen, so we are getting the carbon dioxide gas. We are getting what? Carbon dioxide gas. If we measure here the weight of the carbon dioxide, what we are getting? Okay. Then we can get 44 grams of carbon dioxide. How much you can get?
44 grams of carbon dioxide.
Right. So here this carbon and oxygen masses, if we add, how much 12 plus 32? 44 grams. This is equal to, what is the mass of carbon dioxide? 44 grams. So whether these both are equal or not? These both are equal or not?
Yes.
And here you see, in this chemical reaction, these both are participating in the chemical reaction. Which two are participating in the chemical reaction? Carbon and oxygen. These both are participating in the chemical reaction. So these two are called reactants. What they are called? Reactants. Okay. And after the reaction, what we are getting finally? Carbon dioxide. So this is called a product. What it is called? A product. So therefore, the total mass of the reactant, that is 44 grams before the reaction, is equal to the total mass of the product, that is what, 44 grams of carbon dioxide. In both the cases, the 44 grams remains the same. So this is known as law of conservation of mass. So the mass can neither be created nor destroyed during the chemical reaction. Or we can say that the total mass of the reactants, okay, before the reaction is equal to the total mass of the product after the reaction. This is called law of conservation of mass. Is this clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So now you write this as an example. Okay, example. Note down as it is. How did I write on the board? Similar way, you note down. Completed everything?
Yes, sir.
So the meaning is what? In simple way, if I would like to say, I would like to have a coffee. Okay, I would like to have a coffee. So to make a coffee, what I want coffee. So what I require?
Milk.
So what I'm doing is, I'm taking milk. Okay. I am taking coffee powder. Okay. And I am taking sugar. This I am taking in one closed vessel. In which vessel I am taking?
Closed
vessel. Means what? I am taking one, what you say, like a flask or something. Okay. Otherwise, I am taking one bowl. Okay, in this mixture I am adding in this one. Okay, so here I am taking the milk. Okay, in that I am taking the coffee powder, I am taking the sugar, and I am closing the lid. Okay, so I am closing the lid. Okay, something like this, I am closing the lid. Now for example, you think I am taking milk of, for example, 50 grams of milk I am taking. In that I am adding, for example, like 10 grams of coffee powder, and then I am adding in that some 20 grams of sugar. Okay?
Sir?
Yes?
50 liters.
Liters, but I am measuring in terms of weight, you think. Okay? So 50 milliliters. For example, you think I am measuring the mass And for example, you think in that way. Okay, so 50 grams of milk I'm taking. Okay, and 10 grams of coffee powder and 20 grams of sugar I'm taking. I'm adding all this in this vessel and I'm heating, means I'm boiling this one in a closed vessel. Okay, I'll boil for 5 minutes or 10 minutes, something. Okay, after when it is boiled, then I will take this coffee. Okay, I'll take this coffee and then it cools for some time, little bit cool. And after that, I will see. Now inside, what I'll get here now inside? I'll get coffee, yes or no?
Yes.
I get coffee here. Now if I check the weight of the coffee, if I check only weight of the coffee, how much it would be? Achha. So here you see I have taken 50 grams of milk, 10 grams of coffee, 50 plus 10, 60 plus 20, 80. So here it is 80 grams total, okay, weight of the milk, coffee powder and sugar. Now if I take the coffee here after preparing the total, how much that would be?
50 grams.
Why? But what I said, I am doing it in a closed vessel. Evaporate means what? If the lid is open, then that will get evaporate. But I said that it is a closed vessel. I said, you know, completely packed, airtight. Now, I said that it totally packed, closed vessel. I said closed vessel means water with a tight lid I closed and then I boiled it inside. Now, what happened? So, it will be 80 grams only. And how much? 80 grams only, because yeah, I did it in a closed vessel. Nothing is escaped, nothing is evaporated. So that is in closed vessel. Okay, so here these all three are combining. So these are called, okay, these are called, for example, okay, I'm saying these are called reactants here. Okay, and what is the final I'm getting? That is called product. Okay, product. Now, here the total mass of the reactant is equal to total mass of the product. Yes or no? This is called law of conservation of mass. So law of conservation of mass, what it states, mass can neither be created nor destroyed during the chemical reactions. Okay, but you don't write this as an example in the examination. Okay, this just for your understanding I explained you, but you have to write this example. You can write in the examination anyway if they ask you to explain law of conservation of mass. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Just this I explained you for your understanding. Okay, so that is this clear about the law of conservation of mass?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in the next class I'm going to ask you this all. You have to say the answer.
Yes.
Right. Now, I'm going to explain you one more important law. That is law of constant proportions. Law of constant proportion. Okay, law of constant proportions or law of fixed proportion also we can say. Okay, law of constant proportion. Constant is what? Fixed. Constant proportion or fixed proportion. Okay, now you say, do you know what is the formula of carbon dioxide?
This is CO2.
CO2, very good. So here you know that the carbon dioxide formula is CO2, carbon dioxide. Okay, formula is CO2. Now, for example, here let us take the ratio of carbon and oxygen. So, how many carbons are there? Right, carbons. Only one carbon. And how many oxygens are there? Two. So, one carbon and two oxygens. So, the ratio of carbon and oxygen is 1:2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, the ratio of carbon and oxygen is 1:2. Is this clear? Now you see, I can prepare the carbon dioxide. How can I prepare the carbon dioxide? Okay, so for this you see now, how can I prepare the carbon dioxide? So carbon dioxide I can prepare in many ways. Okay, the first way, I burn the carbon in presence of oxygen. So I'll get carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. This is one method. Okay, and I can heat calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate. Okay, so I will get calcium oxide. Calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. This is another method. Okay, and I make one more reaction, that is for example sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. Okay, I make to react with the hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid. So what I'll get is products. I'll get sodium chloride. Okay, plus water plus carbon dioxide. Okay, so here in these three cases I am getting carbon dioxide here, I am getting carbon dioxide here, I am getting carbon dioxide here. Okay, so here in three different ways I am preparing the carbon dioxide. One, by burning the carbon, okay, with the oxygen, so I am getting the carbon dioxide. Other one, I am heating the calcium carbonate, I am getting the calcium oxide, and of course here also I am getting the carbon dioxide. And third one, I am making to react sodium carbonate with hydrochloric acid. So here also I am getting the products like sodium chloride, water and carbon dioxide. So here I am getting the carbon dioxide. Now you say, what is the formula of carbon dioxide is here?
CO2.
Okay. If I, here also I am getting the carbon dioxide when I am heating calcium carbonate. What is the formula of carbon dioxide here?
CO2.
Very good. Now, here I am preparing the another method like sodium carbonate by reacting with hydrochloric. Here I am getting the carbon dioxide. What is the formula here of carbon dioxide?
CO2.
Okay. So, the methods of preparation of carbon dioxide is different. In different method I prepare the carbon dioxide. Okay, in all the methods I got the carbon dioxide with the formula CO2. Okay, so in all this method the ratio of carbon and oxygen remains same or not?
Same.
So here also the ratio of carbon and oxygen is 1:2, here also 1:2, here also 1:2. That is atoms wise, element wise, and mass wise. Okay, mass wise, carbon mass is 12 and your oxygen mass is 30, sorry, 16, 32. Okay, 12 is to 32. If we cancel, 4 3s are 4 8s. So the mass ratio is 3 is to 8. What is the ratio of mass ratio?
3 is to 8.
Here also the mass ratio is 3 is to 8. This is mass ratio. Okay, and this is element or atoms ratio, atomic ratio here. Okay, and here also mass ratio is 3 is to 8. Here also mass ratio is 3 is to 8. The meaning is what? Whatever the source may be, however you prepare, okay, but the compounds are formed by the combination of fixed combination of elements. This is called law of constant proportions. Is this clear to you? Yes or no? Whatever the method you prepare, whatever the source it may be, but carbon dioxide is made up of fixed ratio of carbon and oxygen. Water is, for example, what is the formula of water? What is the formula of water? H2O. So if you take the water molecule from governmental supply, okay, the water, no, the municipal water you get. So you take one water drop from the municipal water and you take one water drop from the bore. You take one water molecule from the Himalayas. You take one water drop from the London. Okay. Then if you check the water molecule, so water molecule formula remains same. H2O, 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 H2O. The ratio of hydrogen and oxygen remains same. That is 2 is to 1 H2O. Two hydrogens, one oxygen. So the ratio is fixed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This is called the law of constant proportions. What it is called? Proportions. So law of constant proportions, what it states is, okay, so here I will write the definition. Okay, so this definition you have to learn. Okay, the fixed number of, otherwise the elements combine in a fixed ratio to form a compound. Okay, so the elements combine in a fixed ratio to form a compound. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
So the compound is forming. How it is forming? By combining the elements. How they are combining? In a fixed ratio. So this is called the law of constant proportion. So write this definition. Now you write this example. I'll say the example, you write. I'll dictate, you write. Okay? Write example. The atomic ratio of carbon and oxygen. Okay, example you write. Example, the atomic ratio, of carbon and oxygen is 1:2. in carbon dioxide, whatever the method of preparation. Method of preparation. Or. Or. The mass ratio. of carbon and oxygen is fixed. F-I-X-E-D. Fixed. In carbon dioxide. That is. Write like this. Carbon is to oxygen. 12:32. That is equal to 3:8. Write like this. Carbon is to oxygen. Carbon is to oxygen. 12:32. If we cancel 12 means 3 is to 8. Okay, and then you write these methods, different methods you write this one. Carbon plus oxygen, carbon dioxide. Calcium carbonate gives us to calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. These three methods you write. So, these two laws you have to learn. Is this clear? And Dalton's law, so Dalton's atomic theory also you read. Okay. Right. So, with this we stop. Do you have any doubt from today's topic?
No, sir.
So, prepare well, read well. Okay. So, this is all very important for your next classes. If you understand this topic, then we can understand the next topic easily. Okay then. Bye. You can leave now.
Sir?
Yes.
This Saturday also have test, sir?
Yeah, every Saturday will have small test.
Okay.
Okay then. Bye.